Researchers will be able to speak to more families and collect better data thanks to almost $2 million of funding from the government. Social Development Minister Carmel Sepuloni announced this week that growing up in New Zealand, the country's largest longitudinal study, would get $1.9 million to restore its sample size. A funding cut in 2016 saw the number of families in the study drop from 6,800 to just 2,000.
We were worried we wouldn't get the rich analysis of information because obviously less Māori, Pacific, Asian, disabled children, all of those population groups that are really important to understand, there would have been less of them. The other thing is ethically to say, oh, sorry families, we're going to cut 4,500 of you out because we've decided we can only afford to do this number. It doesn't sit right with us.
It's been a really positive experience. It hasn't felt invasive. It really has felt like being part of a journey with the Growing Up in New Zealand team and sort of unifying all these families who are participants. It's been actually a special experience for the kids too to be involved.
Since the study started in 2008, more than 90,000 interviews have been carried out.